Besides introducing the terminology of alphabets, strings, and languages, the major goal of this lesson is to convince you that some functions are not computable. Central to our argument will be the difference between countably infinite sets and uncountably infinite sets. If you aren't familiar with this distinction already, you may be thinking to yourself, "Oh, infinity is a strange enough idea by itself. Now I have to deal with two of them?" Well, it isn't as bad as all that. A countably infinite set is one that you can enumerate. That is, you can say, this is the first element, this is the second element, and so forth. And, this is the really important part, eventually give a number to every element in the set. For some sets, an enumeration is straightforward. Take the even numbers. We can say that 2 is the first one, 4 is the second, 6 the third, and so forth. For some sets, like the rationals, you have to be a little bit clever to find an enumeration. We'll see the trick for enumerating them in a little bit. And for some sets, like the real numbers, it doesn't matter how clever you are. There simply is no enumeration. These are the uncountable sets. In what follows, we'll argue that the set of all strings over an alphabet is countable, and give a few other results that will be useful for thinking about countability in general. Then, we'll show that the set of languages is uncountable.
Let's make this notion of countable and uncountable sets precise with a formal definition. We say that a set is countable if it is finite, or if there's a one-to-one correspondence with the natural numbers. A one-to-one correspondence, by the way, is a function that is one-to-one, meaning that no two elements of the domain get mapped to the same element of the range, and also onto, meaning that every element of the range is mapped to by an element of the domain. For example, here is a one-to-one correspondence between the integers 1 through 6 and the set of permutations of 3 elements. Now, in general, the existence of a one-to-one correspondence implies that the two sets have the same size, that is, the same number of elements. And this actually holds even for infinite sets. That is why we say that there are as many even natural numbers as there are natural numbers, because it's easy to establish a one-to-one correspondence between the two sets. F of n is equal to 2n, for example. For our purposes, we are most interested in showing that for any finite alphabet, the set of strings over that alphabet is countable.